All right, let's get
time
the place
for
questions.
Questions. That's
email.
Right. This first one is from William Pat. He says, at a church service, the minister made an altar call. No one came up. So the pastor started calling people to the front by name. I felt a little embarrassed for the people he called. Is what he did biblical? The pastor said so, but I thought people are guided by the Holy Spirit for prayer.
Well, both. I mean, I just think it might not be too wise to violate the confession. You know, if a parishioner thinks the preacher is going to announce to the congregation what a sinner he is, he's going to keep his mouth shut. So, you know, when you're a pastor, you ought to, you know, hold confidential information. So to call somebody up, there's Charlie Smith sitting in the third row, and I know about that affair you had with that widow 2 years ago. You'd better come and confess it.
Yeah, Charlie, get up
Woo,
here.
Charlie. Charlie will not darken the door of that church again. Yeah. All right, what else?
Okay, this is a viewer who says, I'm in sales. I have a coworker who kisses up to her clients and is totally fake with them so that she'll keep them as clients. Is it wrong to act this way?
Look, some women are very demonstrative, and they're very lovey-dovey, and maybe it's insincere. I don't know, but it's a sales technique. Is it wrong? What's to say it's wrong? I don't know. It's her approach.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, salesmen use all kinds of gimmicks to make sales.
Yes, they do.
To keep customers, but I mean,
male and female.
Male and female. That's right. Yeah. Okay.
Okay. This is Franken, who says, "I've got a promotion at work fairly recently." Or I got a promotion at work fairly recently. I'm starting to realize why the last guy quit the job. I have one girl who's constantly missing deadlines. I've extended grace in the past, and I want to do the same thing this time because she's going through a tough time at home. But if I do that, it winds up creating more work on me and the rest of my team. What do you recommend?
Look, the work environment is not a recovery room. It is not a psychological clinic. It's a place to get a job done. And if people don't perform, they have to be cut and let go, because what the bad performance on one will bring down the performance of an entire team. And I mean, look, if you've got a guy on a football team and every time he gets the ball, he fumbles it, well, before long, your team's going to lose and it's going to be his fault. I saw that in some football that was being played over the weekend. This one guy fumbled two or three times. Chances are he's not going to be on that team anymore. They can't afford it.
Yeah.
So it's the same thing here. I mean, I know it's hard, and you say, well, she's going through a tough time. Well, it'd be much better to fire her and give her a nice check to pay for her bills rather than to keep destroying the team you've got.
Okay, this is Paula, who says, our pastor read Psalm 51:5, which states that I was, quote, sinful at birth, sinful at the time my mother conceived me. So does that mean babies are sinners? I have a baby. Does that mean I have a little heathen child running around the house?
We were conceived in sin. We're all sinners. There isn't one human being who's not a sinner. All have sinned, all, and fallen short of the glory of God. Everybody's a sinner. All have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. So, yes, you've got a little sinner running around. We all do. But is that sinner going to hell, little baby? No. No. Because a baby doesn't know right from wrong and will, if dies, will go to be with the Lord. They're angels. Always behold the face of my Father, which is in heaven. But all that is saying is that we confess that we are sinners. And from the moment of our conception, because of the nature of Adam's fall and the nature of sinful man, rebellion is built into our DNA. And we need to confess it and have cleansing from the Lord.
Yeah.
All right.
This is Jack, who says, when John the Baptist talked about Jesus, he said Jesus would baptize with, quote, fire and the Holy Spirit. What did he mean by fire? Where's the fire?
Well, the fire is the cleansing of the Holy Spirit. The idea of, you know, the Holy Spirit, it is, you know, wind and fire, flames in the day of Pentecost. Fire is a cleansing, and it cleanses people's hearts. And so Jesus baptizes with the Holy Spirit and fire, and the fire comes to cleanse us. So we become different people. If anybody's in Christ, he is a new creation. How do you get that way? You get that by the impurities being burned out of your system spiritually. He's talking spiritually. He's not talking about
physical.
Jesus cooked him over a bed of coals. That's not what he's talking about.